Today I'm going to review the Buck Racing Spark Plug Gap Tool. It's supposed to be very accurate and easy to use, and I'm going to tell you exactly what I think of it. It comes in, you know, it's got its own, I got the 12 millimeter thread, I think. But it comes with three different thread sizes if you want. I got the 12 because I'm using the NGK plugs, and the BMW thread is, I think, 12 millimeters. So it has its own feeler gauges, and it comes with additional feeler gauges to fill in the gaps. Now I'm trying to gap at point 0.06, I believe. Right, because I've got the Beamer Life coils, I had them gapped at 0.5, but I was just messing around and, you know, trying to do 0.6. Here's the problem. On the video, on the YouTube video, the instructions are, let's see, is the instruction, you take this spark plug, right? You put it in and you kind of screw it on until it sticks out just a little bit, right? And then whatever, you know, gauge you want, you put it in, and let's say I want the, you know, the 0.26. So you take that and you just kind of, it's kind of cumbersome. You kind of stick it in there. Let's see, it's hard to, there you go, like that. And good luck holding it in. You get the point. But it's hard to do this, even, you know, shit just keeps falling out. So you stick it in like that. Now I have this gapped at 6, but it should be easy and instantaneous and super accurate, but it's not. And the reason is, if you know, put this, yeah, 0.26 in there, and you take this thing and you kind of screw it down, and it'll push that prong down, right? However, when it pushes it down and the feeler gauge stops the prong, in theory it should be gapped. But when you release it, that prong is going to snap back, because it has a little elasticity. It'll snap back to be a little bit bigger than the 0.26, right? So I was like, well, how the hell are you gonna, that's impossible to make the metal bend instantaneous like that. So I tried lower gauges, like, you know, I even tried all the way down to the feeler gauge for 0.22. So I was like, well, maybe if I gap it for 0.22 using this feeler gauge in there, the pressure to push it down to 0.22, when I release it, it'll pop back to, you know, 0.26, but nope, it was still very, very loose. So there's no way to do an accurate gap. So what you end up having to do, just like a normal one of these, is you just have to twist it. You know, you set it, you take it out, you measure it with your 0.26, and then you stick it back in, and then you kind of crush that prong, and you, hopefully you have enough sensitivity to feel the pressure pushing the prong to bend it just ever so slightly. And you're doing this multiple times until you get that prong to bend correctly. Now, there's a high chance that you're gonna end up over bending so that the prong is too small. Like, the gap is too small. It's no longer 0.26. It might end up being, you know, 0.23 or, yeah, 0.23, 0.22, whatever. Now, unfortunately, there's no way to bend the thing. There's nothing here to bend it back. So you have to end up using one of these. So it's kind of pointless. And it was very expensive. It was like $65 or $50-something. And I got it overnight because I was so excited. And I got to tell you, I'm pretty disappointed. So I would recommend The only good thing is that it has the feeler gauge for the, you know, 026, whereas this thing here is not really that many increments. So you can see 025, but there's no 026. So yeah, I mean, I basically paid $65 for this thing. And I wouldn't recommend it. Just you know, use one of these or find a set of feeler gauges and then combine it with this. Much cheaper than this piece of crap. So, you know, I paid $30. It ended up being like $100 because I wanted it overnight, and I was super excited about having a, you know, accurate gap device. Anyways, that's that.